Hey everybody, Cyber War, how you guys doing? I don't even know what to say, but I didn't even think about an intro. Holy Nikes. So I'm just here at Everest Harbor. I'm in the PTU. Look at that, it's got that written down there at the bottom of the screen. I'm in the PTU because the PU is totally bork. I wish they stopped running events. I think everybody has said that to me too as well. Just stop. Yeah, stop. Let's get the server stable. Get it running efficiently before we do some more stupid events. They've been running events for 2 or 3 months straight, and it's driving me and driving everybody nuts. But hey, you know, I guess they really want to test the crap out of everything and figure out ways to make it better, but in the meantime, nobody's been really able to play. Lots of 30Ks, lots of problems, but it's definitely a growing year here for Star Citizen. You know, I knew it was coming. I thought last year would have been the growing year, but it's this year. Persistent Enemy streaming is more difficult than they even anticipated. I mean, they knew it was going to be difficult, but I don't think anyone foresaw this happening. But we'll get through it. It's not like there haven't been rough times in Star Citizen before. It's just part of game development. So don't fret. The PTU is open for everybody to come test out. And it's actually running great, man. My frames are amazing. I think I've only had like 130K. And played it yesterday and today. Yeah, there's still bugs. Going to be bugs in alpha. There are going to be bugs in a game no matter if it's finished or not. But yeah, things are going good. So I got a Nomad. I traded in, or I upgraded, didn't trade in. I upgraded my original like legacy pack that I bought back in 2013. And just upgraded this. I used to have a 300i and I really don't like the ship. So I kind of just sat in my hangar. So I got me a Nomad instead, which I absolutely love. Oh my god, it's so loud in my ears. I haven't picked up any paints for it yet. I actually owned one of these when it first came out. I owned it for quite a while actually, and I kind of just wanted to change the pace. So I don't think I've had one for over a year, but yeah, it's definitely fun. I was in my buddy's Nomad, I think like a week or two ago, and I'm like, you know what? I really need to get that ship back. It's just so cool. I think the only thing that would make it cooler would be windows inside, not just the window that's in the back here. But I've already loaded up my mule. I want to go test out, see what bunker AI is doing. You're probably like, oh no, great, another bunker. But hey, PTU, we gotta test the AI, see if it's any good. I went and did the trial mission last night. Wasn't expecting anything fierce, and boy, man, they were gunning for me. So let's see if that's a consistent attribute of 319.1. Ah, god! If you haven't done so already, please smash. Oh, I have different controls in the PTU than PU. I haven't loaded them in yet. If you haven't done so already, please smash that subscribe button, man. I'd really appreciate it. I'm trying to reach 1,000 subscribers. I'm trying to get monetized on the channel because I really could use the extra money. I work from home. I'm disabled, and any additional revenue that would keep me off having to get government assistance would be amazing. Yeah, I'm trying to earn my money. I don't really like taking handouts. But, so that's what I'm doing. I'm getting my YouTube channel in check. I got my Twitch channel already monetized. And, I can just sit around and play Star Citizen endlessly if I make money at it. And, annoy you people. Alright, so let's, but I appreciate everyone who's already subscribed. You guys are really helping me out a lot. Helps out the channel. I got my links down below if you want to check them out. I got my PC specs in there if anyone was wondering. A lot of people have been, not a lot, but a few people have asked. So it just makes it easy, and there's links there to Amazon if you want to pick them up. Those are affiliate links. that would actually give me a little percentage of the sale too. It doesn't cost you anything, but if you're looking to pick up the same equipment I'm running or whatever. What did I do? You can use those links below, or even if you just want to shop at Amazon, you can click on those links and then do your normal shopping, and I'd still get an affiliate. I guess you call it a kickback. That'd be much appreciated. And it literally doesn't cost you anything. Helps me make a few extra pennies. So here we are. We are over Hurston. I gotta go to HDSF tomorrow. I don't ever go to this security post too much. Let's go check it out. I don't know what kind of biome is over there. It's so pretty. It's so pretty. I wish this was real life. I was feeling very stormtrooper-y today, so I put on the digital camo and got my bug mask on. I love this mask. I think it's amazing. Yeah, I've been running a poll this week to see what everyone's favorite cutter paint job. So if you haven't participated, it's down in the community link on my page. I'm gonna leave the cutter one up today, and it's a four part. So today's the first day for the cutter's vote. And then tomorrow I'll have another set of paint to vote on. And then the following day, or 2 days after that, I'll have another set of paints to vote on. And the winners of all three of those votes will face off in a final round. And we'll see whichever one likes best, you know? It's not what's the best paint, it's just what everyone likes the most, you know? Because what's best is always relative to personal taste anyway, so... Don't feel bad if your paint that you love didn't win. Because, you know, if it makes you feel happy, then it wins, right? And it's the way I look at things in life. If you enjoy it and it makes you happy, then, well, you're winning. And there's nothing wrong with people having differences of opinions or taste or anything like that. You know? It's part of life. Not everyone's going to agree. All right. Tamar. Anything down here? No, it's BPU. There's probably no crash anywhere. I don't know why I'm coming in so slow. I think it's because my controls are different here. So I'm just kind of getting adjusted to them. My mouse feels like it's really, really overly sensitive. And I'm just kind of too lazy to bring the control file over here and load it in. But yeah, I'm taking a break from the PU. I figured, you know, the game's going to give me some stress. I'll just go over to PTU, hang out, do stuff. It's all meaningless. I'm not, you know, worried about it. This gets wiped out every time they put a new patch out. But can at least have some fun in the meantime, right? Look at that outfit.
Oh my god.
Dude, he looks so bad. So badass. And I love this new backpack that they gave us. Subscribers, you can buy this in the subscriber store. I think it's $4 or $5. I just love the black camo. I might actually pick up an extra one. They have two. They have a woodland green one, military, and then they have another green one that's like, I don't even know, color shifting or whatever, depending on how you look at it. I never really checked it out. Maybe I'll pick it up and look at it. Just put it in my hanger. If I like it, I'll keep it. If not, I'll melt it down. But yeah, here we go. All right. God, I didn't even check to see if I brought anything with me. I have ammo. Yes. Oh, I got 11 mags. Okay. I couldn't remember what I had. Oh, this is garbage. I can go away. Couldn't remember what I had left over from yesterday. Not really looking for loot, because since PTU, the loot doesn't matter, but check out and see how the AI is functioning today, huh? Server's running so buttery smooth. Nice. Ooh, he's Already shooting at me. I didn't even see him. Look at him. There he is. Got him. That was cool. There's a guy there. Got him. They're aware something fishy's going on. Get him? I got him. I don't like letting these guys get a chance to even shoot at me because, oh, he was attacking someone there. It's a guard. Or is it? Yeah, I'm at Hurston. Okay, that's a guard. What's that? I'm sorry, something flew by my window. It scared the crap out of me. Big bird. Big old birdie. Shit. Go now. Ooh, I took some damage. Ooh, God, I almost died there. Get healed up here. Okay, they're pretty well aware here. If you didn't know about the multi or the med gun, you bring it out and you hit B, it'll point at your wrist and then you can zap yourself and heal yourself. And then there's like other settings. You can turn it into advanced and then hit auto in case you have like different type of injuries, and it'll give you the type of medicine you would need to counteract the effects of it so you can get to a med bed or to heal you up. So this is just a short little medical tutorial. Wrong button. And when I'm doing battle medic with my org, I try and rescue a lot of people. When I go in under a hostile situation, I try to tractor beam them to me instead of going to where they are, because obviously where they were is a spot you can get shot. So I usually get undercover where I can see the injured party, and then I'll tractor beam them over to me, put them under concealment and cover, and then I'll revive them instead of running out there and trying to revive them instantly. Put this one on. I'm not really looting, but I'm just picking up a better weapon. Let's see what kind of stuff they're carrying. Nothing. Okay. Oh my god. Oh, I'm so lucky I didn't get a crime stat. He scared the crap out of me. And you get loot. Sorry, I didn't mean to shoot that guy in the face. He just took it like, oh, okay. Guess it didn't get through his armor, so he didn't get hurt. They're cool. Oh, they're putting Ninetales stuff in the crate? That kind of sucks. Unless it's modified in a different way. I don't know. I wish they had an examine type thing for armor. So you could, like, get a good look at it without having to put it on. But it's not that important. And CIG, please don't waste time doing that. Let's get the servers in good working order. I know the server tech, I know server like performance itself can't really keep up with this game, no matter what you do. They need the whole new infrastructure to be installed, which is happening. So, I mean, these bad server days aren't here forever. the new server technology that was being adopted was planned out to be coincide with server meshing. So, and since server meshing is kind of running a little behind, by each other, I don't even want to risk shooting the good guy. The server meshing's been put on hold. Oh, it's not put on hold, but it's running behind because of how long persistent entity stream is taking. Okay, he got it. They're still running out the infrastructure, so the tech, the hardware, the hardware is being put in place. I'm gonna take his ammo too. You actually run server meshing, and the speeds on the new stuff is just insane. We're talking magnitudes of 100 times faster than the existing records for enterprise systems for read and write. So there's like absolutely no bottleneck anymore. And this is what's happening with our game right now, is that it's bottlenecking because there's so much data coming in and out of the system. Sorry, buddy. Some ammo. So that's why things pause and you gotta wait for the server to respond, because it's just running too many commands and prompts at once. But you know, but we're testing it out now, so by the time the new hardware is in place, man, they'll have that code so efficient and running so well that they'll be able to scale it quickly. At least that's my hope. As everything with game development, not everything goes as planned. In other news, they've taken Squadron 42 off the store temporarily. They're doing a price change on it, which I'm suspecting will be a price increase, because all, you know, AAA games now are going for like $70, and I think they were only charging $40 for it, if I remember right. I don't know, I've had Squadron 42 for so long, I think I paid $20 for it back in 2013. But, I suspect it'll be back in time for CitizenCon, which is in October, and I have a feeling that they're going to have a release date finally for it. CitizenCon would make the most sense. In Los Angeles this year, all the stars in that show or in the game can show up and promote the crap out of it. I think usually games go through a 1-year promotional cycle, so they'll probably have a huge like vertical slice of the game, because I know they started working on a vertical slice over a year ago for Squadron 42. We haven't heard anything about it since. They've taken all the data off the progress tracker, and I think they're updating it, but last time I checked it just a couple days ago, so much of Squadron 42 was finished. And Sandy Roberts, the wife of Chris Roberts, she's been posting a lot of pictures online of them doing pickup shots with the actors and motion capture, kind of like fixing scenes and stuff that didn't work out right, so they're redoing them. That's always done at the end of the process of video games and movies, for that matter. Chris Roberts is making this game really, really high production value, so I'm hoping that we have a great announcement at CitCon this year. I really, really am excited for Squadron 42. It was, in fact, that Squadron 42 was what got me into Star Citizen. Never was a fan of like big MMOs, RPGs and stuff, but Star Citizen totally changed that. But Squadron 42, I was like, oh, I'll check out the multiplayer universe. And I'd say for the first 6 or 7 years it wasn't anything really great, but I've been playing it consistently probably almost every day for the last 3.5 years. So, it's really come a long way. I remember I took a couple years off just to let it cook. And then I saw this guy's video on YouTube, his name's Cobra TV, And dude, he made me laugh and he was showing me stuff in Star Citizen. If you haven't checked him out on YouTube, I highly suggest you do. His name's Cobra TV. He was a big No Man's Sky creator. Had a huge following, and he literally left No Man's Sky. People hated him for it too, just to come play Star Citizen. They, you know, but hey, that's what he was looking for. You know, everybody has that right. You know, people don't have to get mad about it. Just people just realize, hey, you know, this is what I'm looking for. That's what makes me happy. There you go. Well, anyway, his videos were making me freaking laugh my butt off, and he was showing me all this stuff in Star Citizen I hadn't seen because I'd been taking a couple years off. I don't know why I'm going to Aberdeen. There's really nothing to do out there except pleasure. So I got the game installed again. Seen how it worked on my new system. And I realized I probably need an upgrade. So I started playing, and then I was watching his show, and I actually ran into him. I realized I'm on the same server he is. I know exactly where he's at, so I actually ran into him on the train. And he started talking to me, and of course, I didn't have my microphone set up like an idiot. So I'm like talking to him, and I realized, oh, I don't have my mic on. And by then, he was already like off onto his mission. So I joined his org, and I just hung out and been hanging out with those guys ever since. One of the best orgs I've ever been a part of, man. Just amazing group of people over there at the Cobra Force. And we're friends with so many of the other orgs. It's all just a great camaraderie. There's no bitter rivalries. You know, there are some bad eggs out there. I guess I'll call them that, you know, take everything way too seriously and they contribute little to nothing for the game or the community. We just come in to try to disrupt everything. But we laugh at them. But overall, you know, everyone, 99.9% of all the people we hang out with, encounter in the org and outside the org, are just amazing, amazing people. It's a wonderful little community. You know, it's the type of org is you get out of it what you put into it. You know, there's no fees, there's no, you know, nothing like that. We have everything for everyone. We're not a pirate org, but there are some people in our org who do that. No, but it's not like an org sanctioned thing. And we just ask that if you're going to go out and do that, you don't bring any bad flack to the org itself. So we actually have some members that do have redacted information on the org website, but yeah, so if you're looking for an org, you know, give Cobra Force a check out, you know, want to decide to join up, you know, stop in, say hi and introduce yourself. And if you don't, you know, good luck in finding the org that's right for you. That's all I got to say. My best advice, since a lot of people have been telling me that they are looking for orgs, my best advice for finding an org is to find an org that wants nothing from you. There's a lot of orgs out there that want you to pay them, you want you to give them credits, they want you to devote your time. We have an open door policy at Cobra Force. You come in, come and go as you please. Your participation level is entirely up to you. There's no fines or, you know, fines or like taxes or monthly dues like some orgs do. So, you know, just try to find an org that wants nothing from you. They want to provide you with fun. They want to provide you with camaraderie. They want to provide you, you know, and then the more you put into that org, the more of that you get out of it, you know. But you need to have that existing already in the org that you join. You know, that's the best advice I could give to anybody when they're looking for an org. with the ninja flare like that, I would expect Gladius. Yeah, it's a bad guy. And it is a Gladius. Okay, it's Roderick Enfield Little Benny. Okay. Quite the strange name, CIG. Where is Doug Starkiller? I haven't seen him around in a while. I used to run into him at least a couple times a week. Give this guy a missile. Oh, wrong button. He's talking to me, but I don't hear him. Is that gimbals on this thing? Or do? What happened to him? Looks like he's down for the count. Wonder if that turret from the station took him out. Either that or he hit the ground. I saw him take a bunch of damage on the MFD. I don't see his remains out there anywhere. There's that. That's him right in front of me. Okay, let's see what he's got. He's wearing the villain armor. Come with me, pal. I love that flight suit he's wearing. It's all put together with duct tape. Yeah, so I'm not even at the station with Earth. I'm at a derelict outpost, so he probably hit the ground. There's three guards there. There's a guard up top. Two guards. There's five or six. Guy in the back there. I'm just trying to assess how much battle I'm gonna have to do to get this one little package. Anything out here? Probably be best to park over here. Listen to that echo going through the valley. I love that. Loot crate. There's a guy over there. Just reverberating through the valley here. It's been bounced. That's so cool. The sound design team has really, really been stepping it up. I love it. Oops, the guy's over there still. I thought I took him out. mind. Oh, here comes the ship. He's attacking me. I gotta get out of here. I don't have great shields on this thing. Power to shield. Working balance. Come on, Millard. I don't know what kind of random name generation they use in this game, but it's freaking hysterical. Another one bites the dust. All right. It literally sounded like that explosion went off and then echoed back. Did you hear that? That would be freaking cool if it did. Oh, I know why I was having such problems flying. I still got my landing gear up. Wrong way. I'm really having a hard time flying. My controls are all wrong. I feel like they've tuned up the AI a little bit, because the last patch, man, the AI was so bad. And I don't know if that was just because the server tech was so bad or performance was so bad. And I know they kind of de-escalated them a little bit because, they made them less lethal, I guess, they said. And, I found them to be just super pushover, so. I guess it all depends on server tick, server performance, what's going on in the verse, how effective the AI becomes here. Alright, so we got some server lag going on. Without me turning on the net graph, I have no idea what's going on with the server. But you people don't want to see all them numbers sitting up there at the top, so I turn it off. We'll be right back. Ooh. That matches my outfit. I'll take that. Still radar locked, so that means there's still an NPC out here somewhere that's tracking me. So I didn't get them all, but there's someone out here somewhere. I think they have a pretty effective vision of like 40 to 50 meters, if not longer. Especially if you're moving around or making noise. I got my box, so I'm just gonna get out of here. I'm not worried about that last guy or two. Really wish the lights were better on this ship. They're kind of not good. Can't go outside without my helmet on. Yeah, I'm gonna drop off this box, get my money, maybe check some of the loot around here, and then I'm gonna call it a day. Really appreciate you guys hanging out with me. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button. I'd really appreciate you guys are the best. Everyone. And check out the poll I put in the community. Tomorrow, I'm going to update it tomorrow with the second selection to vote on. And we'll get that finished, man. I love you guys. Be safe. May the verse be with you. May your servers have good ticks, your profits be high, and your days in the verse be pleasant. Cyber War. Catch you guys later.